What's your sense right now in the world of electrification and the way he's managed to just pound the shorts?
Yeah. Well, you know, it's very interesting. EVs are the future of the industry. The question, though, is when's the payoff and what's the adoption rates? And if you look at what Tesla has done, they have really created a very kind of iconic brand for electrification. He's done a very good job with his organization in creating an aspirational brand for electric vehicles. And I think investors right now are standing back and saying the big macros, electrification is coming. They have a good brand. You know, they're ramping the plant in China right now. They're building the plant in Europe. And I think they're also viewing it as beyond just an automotive maker. You know, they have a solar business. They have an energy storage business. So I think all that wrapped together, investors are, you know, getting very excited. The question, though, is can they consistently be profitable? And, you know, we'll see that in the next quarter's results.
You think is the bigger story adoption or cost-efficient manufacturing, at least in the Tesla case?
Well, I think, for the whole industry with all, you know, the electrified models are showing up this year. The question is, will customers to the same degree they have for Tesla? And to me, it's really around the demand factor. From a cost standpoint, yes, it's still more expensive than internal combustion engines, and consumers are very pragmatic. But over the next 4 or 5 years, that cost differential will go away. The question is, will there be natural demand to get mass adoption? And Tesla's done a really good job on early adopters and creating that brand.
So you think people are buying Teslas to buy Teslas, not necessarily because they're EV?
You talk to most Tesla customers, they're buying it because of the brand.
Right.
And they get the added factor is, hey, we can be cool and help the environment because it's electrified as well. And there's a lot of discussion around, you know, Tesla's challenges of ramping up and becoming a mass manufacturer, which is a lot of challenges that they're working their way through. But what's not talked about is when you have an electrified product, there's lots of software management in that. They have a big advantage over the traditional OEMs as they are just now starting to introduce some of their electrified products, and it's yet to be seen, can they master that? I thought was interesting, the CEO of VW last week in an internal meeting said, listen, we are far behind on software and we need to up our game. That's a really interesting comment coming as they're launching their ID3, which says, you know, are they having issues as they ramp and master the software skills necessary? Who knows?
Speaking of software, autonomous is also, again, in part of the investment case for Tesla, where a lot of people who are positive on the company's prospects believe it has an opportunity to dominate. When you were at Ford, we were talking about autonomous. That's already starting to rearview mirror, so to speak, be in the rearview mirror. How many more years until we really are actually starting to see these vehicles? And why has it been so much more difficult, perhaps, than some of the optimists had thought?
Well, I think, you know, initially there was a lot of optimism around this. But clearly you have to, whenever you introduce a new technology, you can get 90, 95% of mastery of what you need. It's the last 5% that's really hard. And in the case of autonomous vehicles, you're designing for rules of the road, but then you also have to design for the unwritten rules of the road. And so I think that is pushing out some of the timelines. And in the case of Tesla, I think what some are thinking is, listen, they've been on the road. They collect a lot of data from their cars. They do over-the-air updates. If and when AVs come to pass, which they will just be pushed back, will Tesla have an advantage because they have that network of users? And could those network of users use that for a car service or things of that nature?